Hi, I'm Kees, and I help people from doing to being, and welcome so much to this video about ego death. Well, this sounds very grand, it's a very big term, and it sounds very, I would say, Star Wars-ish, where you, where it's like this big thing, like the Death Star, it's like ego death. My ego has died and now I'm floating. So, okay, back to reality. Because what is ego death really? Well, first of all, to know what ego death is and why it's important, you have to understand what ego is actually. And ego is actually the part of you that believes you're separate and that then and you're only, let's say, this body or this experience. And then bind yourself through identifications with different things. So if we think we are this body and this reality, and we're just this person we've created out of thoughts and ideas that we've believed, and those thoughts and ideas get a certain energy. They get energy invested in them. There's a sort of investment that is being done in the ego. And that's why it feels like a solid thing for most people. They don't even know that they have an ego. And it's different than what's the popular term for ego, because this is more the spiritual term for ego, because the popular term for ego is that you're, for example, thinking that you know something or thinking that you can do something while you actually can't or don't know that you can. So let's say if I say, well, I can be a fast runner if I train for 2 years, for example. I have no clue if this is true, but if I state something like that, that could be from ego. That's the popular term, but that's not what we're meaning here. What we're meaning here with ego is actually your self-definition, and with that, you're holding yourself back because you're bringing yourself and your beliefs about yourself to every situation. Even though you don't really accurately know what you can or can't do. Do you know exactly how long you would be able to run until you literally fall down? Most people have no idea. I, of course, also don't have an idea, because this is not possible for us to know unless we do it. And then maybe, let's say if you recover and you do it another time, you'll end up somewhere else. So. Of course, I wouldn't recommend you doing this. But the idea with the ego is that you have a sort of self-definition. You could say these are your limitations, and they can consist of certain feelings about yourself. I feel that I'm a good person. I feel that I'm a compassionate person. I feel that I'm a bad person. I feel that I'm a criminal person. I feel... you can have also some thoughts about yourself, and you think, I'm really good at this, I'm not so good at this. And let's say if you have the idea, I'm really good at, I used to do, for example, karate. If you would say, I'm really good at karate, then someone else that also does karate, for example, you need to be able to beat them because you say you're really good at karate, right? So if you build some a self-image of yourself, any type of idea, whether that's good or bad or any type of definition, by default is not true, because it might be related to one point in time where you could objectively say, okay, this is true, but it's always not true in relation to time and in relation to when you compare different people. But in truth, there is no ego, because there is no self as we think that there is, right? This is the idea of non-duality. There's just consciousness, there's just energy, and part of that energy is the body through which we experience the world, and everything we see and experience is experienced through the five senses. And because we are perceiving through the five senses, we have the idea that we are everything we sense, and that we're only limited to what we can sense with the body. And we identify with the body, with the thoughts, with the body-mind And not so much with the spirit or that which is actually there. So we also don't want to identify with that because it's everything, so you can't basically. You can't identify with consciousness because it's just a word, but for everything. And yeah, that's not something you can really use that way. So ego death is actually where you realize that a part of that self-definition, first of all, becomes conscious. You understand, okay, wait, I've been thinking that I'm like this. Or I've been defining myself like this. Or I have a certain rule for myself. I must do this. All these musts and definitions of ourselves and ideas for ourselves, all these things, when they are believed, they have a certain energy, and that energy altogether forms a sort of tight grip or energy ball, usually in our chest and our stomach area. And that is actually an experience of ego. Through that experience, we actually feel limited. So what ego death is that we first of all understand, like I said, that we become conscious of a part of our ego. So that could say be one self-definition or one limitation or one tough feeling we have from the past which we've been carrying. It could be a little bit of micro trauma, we could say, or it could be a big trauma as well, which we're carrying, that is usually emotions related to the memory. But anything that's related to this energy ball, if we become aware of a piece and we look at it with full acceptance, and we also, from the place that we realize that we're okay that this is there, but also that we understand that this is a false self-definition, because any type of self-definition is a false self-definition. So when we look at it like that and we experience it, we go into it with our pure nature of that which we are, which is pure awareness or pure consciousness or pure energy. We go into it without any idea that this is bad. Then the self-definition or the limitation or the piece of ego can actually expand and let go. And usually there's a process that you also feel the energy dissipate. You feel sort of a release, and you can also sometimes bodily get certain reactions. Some people, let's say, burp or shock, you know, like, oh, you know, and some people, they yell or they scream or they have these sort of bodily reactions. And sometimes it's just something that's in the mind or very subtle. It could be, you know, like I said, it could be a sigh of, you know, a release, a little bit like that. And when we after that, when we integrate that, so we realize that we're actually a little bit more free, because we let go of that self-definition. And by letting go of that self-definition or that piece of ego, what happens is actually ego death happens. A little bit of our ego actually dies. And how that happens is quite simple. That is, like I said, by looking at our self-definition, by understanding that it's false, and by accepting it, and through accepting it and being with it, it lets go and it opens up. And when it opens up, two feelings happen. One is the ego death feeling that we have. We can feel a little bit depressed. We can feel a little bit that something died inside of us. And that's usually a very subtle feeling. And then there's another feeling usually, and that's a subtle disorientation, because we've been binding ourselves and we've been defining ourselves in a certain way. And we, instead of that prison, we get freedom in return. But we don't know what to do with this freedom. We don't know how to orient ourselves in the beginning. So that takes a little bit to get used to that. But both of these feelings together, the feeling of ego death and the feeling of disorientation, are both a very good thing. And they are what's commonly being called integration. The integration of the letting go of our limitations. And that is how the ego slowly, over time, dies. And sometimes something can happen in which we realize that lots of these self-definitions are actually not true. And then a part of, or a bigger chunk of the ego can actually die at once. Those are quite big happenings. And I've been through one with my spiritual awakening 5 years ago, where I think I've lost, let's say, 40% of my ego or something like that. And I felt very disoriented for months after that, actually. And also I felt depressed. But I had the same thing happen to me over and over as I've looked and realized after that experience that I wanted to let go of more of that self-definition, more of that ego. And with that, more of my ego has died. Or that self-definition has died, which makes it more possible for me to flow and to relax in the moment, etc. But it's not that personal investment in that energy, in that limited energy. We can be very attached to that. And it's a hard process to let go of your ego like that. It's ego death is hard. And it can be quite painful as well. For example, if I find a big piece of ego still, and I focus on that and I let go of it, then the integration usually lasts about a week. And then in that week, usually the first 2 days, I can feel something, let's say, dying inside me, or I can feel a little bit of depression. And this is just a sense I have in my system. And I also can feel this disorientation a little bit. For example, I usually then say to my girlfriend, I don't know what to do with my life, or I don't know what to do with myself, because I just get a little bit disoriented. And now I understand the process a lot better. But when this used to happen to me a couple of years ago, I had no idea of what ego death was or how this worked. How this integration process works, and how you actually need to, because it's kind of like a reconfiguration of everything, and everything was attached to everything. And if you let go of a piece of ego, the ego needs to sort of reshuffle itself and reintegrate, and also the freedom needs to sort of reintegrate. So there's quite a little bit of a process going on. It can be really subtle for some people, but also quite big and intense for other people, related also to what the release or the part that you've let go, how intense it was to let that go, how much emotion came up and things like that. So yeah, it's a very cool process. And let me know what you think about this, and if you've ever been through a little bit of ego death. Sometimes people have this also in plant medicine ceremonies. I've never done any plant medicine, but I've had lots of people talk to me that experienced ego death or a part of ego death after a plant ceremony. And also they realize they're more than just a person. They realize they're bigger than the ego, and then the ego never really catches hold in the same thing, and they can be catapulted sometimes into a sort of spiritual awakening where they understand that they're more than the body, they're a spirit, you know, they're bigger, or their consciousness and their awareness. And this realization can be scary for people as well. So, you know, I'm really interested if you have ever had any experiences with ego death, and or any spiritual awakening experiences you would love to share, or if you have any questions, please let me know, that I can talk about it in the next video. So leave them below in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm also evolving, so I would love to evolve together. Thank you for sharing. Bye.